Brown, he decision, Dennis Moyer, Florentino Fernandez, Jorge Fernandez, Luis Rodriguez, and knockout Willie Tawil. He KO'd Benny Perrette for the title and Gaspar Ortega to defend it. Overall, he has won 24 out of 26, scoring 9 knockouts. His losses were on decisions. Bahama, whose real name is William Butler, has gone through his last 7 bouts with just a draw to Mara's record. Among his victims were Joey Giambra and Jose Gonzalez. He has had 80 fights, winning 66 and losing 11 with 3 draws. He has scored 21 knockouts, was stopped once himself back in 1954, after which he won 23 in a row. The 28-year-old Bahama stands 5 feet 9, while the 23-year-old Griffith is 5 feet 7 and a half. At the New York State Commission weigh-in today, Bahama was 156, while Griffith was 150 and 3 quarters. In just a few minutes, a 10-round middleweight fight between Emil Griffith and Yama Bahama will get underway. A nice crowd on hand anticipating a good fight, and here to get the proceedings underway, as usual, our very good friend, Johnny Addy.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. 2 weeks from tonight is the next boxing show here in the Garden, and it will present Don Frumer against the former welterweight champion of the world. Here he is, Benny Kid Perrette. Now, here are the ring officials assigned by the New York State Athletic Commission. The judges, Tony Castellano, Adi Idala, timekeeper George Bannon,
with the eye shade,
counting for the knockdowns, referee Joe Loscalzo, and the referee for the main event, Harry Kessler. 10 rounds from Bimini, British West Indies, wearing white trunks, weighing 156, Yama Bahama. Bahama. His opponent from the West Side and the Virgin Islands. He's wearing black trunks. He weighs 150 and 3/4 pounds. The welterweight champion of the world, Emil Griffith. Griffith. Main event, 10 rounds. Another bout to follow.
Good evening, Yama. Good evening, Emil. You've both boxed New York State before, and you know our rules and regulations. I want a nice, clean fight. Keep your punches high. In the event of a fall, slip, or knockdown, go back to the far corner and stay there until I wave you back. When I tell you to step back, please step back. Shake hands now. Come out boxing.
Scoring here in New York on a round basis with a supplementary point system. A mandatory 8 count of a man goes down, if a man is floored 3 times in 1 round, that is it. It's a 10-round go. Emil Griffith, black trunks, Yama Bahama in white. These boys know how to fight. It should be a good one. Bahama, a natural middleweight. Griffith, invading the middleweight ranks. Emil's title is not at stake, as you've been told. Harry Kessler, the referee, the well-known metallurgist. These boys are going to keep their hands high until and if they get tired. This Bahama can be a real cutie in there. He knows that Griffith likes to take charge of a fight. He'll probably try to do it himself. This bout was fought at a 155-pound contract, give or take a pound. Watch for a Bahama when he jabs or hooks to go to side to side, and side to side to neutralize the counter-punching of Griffith.
Both of you locked up. Both of you, one step, let's go.
Thank you. some height on Griffith. And it's making it pay off up to the moment.
Let's go one step back. Turn it in.
10 seconds to go on round one. There's the bell. Coming up to round two, Madison Square Garden, Yarmouth, Bahama. On the left, the white trunks, Emil Griffith in black. Griffith, the welterweight champion, and in this over-the-weight match, no title at stake, a 10-rounder. You're going to see some good boxing. Al Griffith is getting to sneaking that right hand by the guard of Yahama. He's a welterweight. You can see from his back that Griffith in the black has the frame of a middleweight with those sloping shoulders. Give him plenty of power. See that? He'll be a middleweight before long, no question about it. It's an important bout. The winners has the possibility of fighting Ray Robinson here in the Garden on October 14th. That Griffith counter punch, that good left hook you saw. Co-manager Gil Clancy, former boxing coach at Strathmore Vanderbilt, and his other co-manager with the glasses outside the ring, Howie Albert, a millinery man, and the veteran trainer who has added so much to his career, Sid Martin, a very potent force, this trio in that corner of Emil Griffith. On the other side of the ring, Yarmouth, Bahama's corner shows Bobby Melnick, his manager, and Pat Colavito, his trainer. Bobby is the one inside the ring facing him. He's also been the manager of Tiger Jones. So Bobby Melnick, as you probably guess, has been on television more than a few times. Been a very good fight so far. Fairly close one, I would say, before a good crowd at Madison Square Garden. We're waiting for the bell for round three of this 10-rounder. Bahama, the white trunks, Griffith, and the black trunks. Round three. Probably the, at least the smartest, if not the best fighter that Griffith has ever fought. starting now, if you're scoring with us, you'll find it pretty hard to judge. Is a bit more flat-footed of the two to give him a little power. Griffith likes to get up on his toes just a little bit. To go in round three. Griffith has knocked out his last three opponents, Willie Tawil, Gaspar Ortega, Benny Kid Perret. To the left of the left eye of Yama Bahama. 10 seconds left in round three. There's the bell. Coming up to round four, Madison Square Garden, Yama Bahama from Bimini in the British West Indies in the white trunks. Emil Griffith, formerly from the Virgin Islands, now of New York City in the black. Griffith's welterweight title not at stake, in case you've just joined us. If you watch the moves that Bahama makes, you'll see a throwback to the old-time boxers. But some of his moves are neutralized because Griffith is so fast. And Bahama can remain in complete control of himself and the fight. Kessler is a referee who likes to let the men fight out of a clinch. These boys don't have to be told to break. Occasionally because they solve each other's style, so they start new tactics. Yeah. at bell ending round four. Very even contest. Pretty good crowd here at Madison Square Garden tonight. And among the celebrities, Dr. Ralph Bunche, the Undersecretary for Political Affairs for the United Nations. There's Dr. Bunche looking down at his hands, now up at the ring. He's with his son, by the way, and seems to be enjoying the bout. Here's something of interest to all sports fans. Saturday is Sports Day on ABC. The best in boxing, the best in bowling on Make That Spare After the Fight and ABC's Wide World of Sports. Next week, you'll watch the Cheyenne Rodeo from Wyoming, and the following week, the World Hydroplane Championship from Seattle, Washington. Don't forget next Friday, the College All-Star Football Game from Chicago over most of these ABC stations. Coming up, NCAA football, the American Football League schedule, and the Orange Bowl Classics. All on ABC, television's number one network for sports. And here's round five, Yama Bahama, Emil Griffith. Bahama in white trunks, Griffith in black. Very even fight in our humble estimation. Left in the round. The action has slowed down a little bit, as we suggested it might. That usually happens when two good boxers figure each other out. Seems to have gone into a defensive pattern, or he's waiting to get over one good punch. He's lost some of his aggressiveness. 1 minute to go in round five. Crowd calling for more action. Kessler keeps telling them to work their way out. At Madison Square Garden, Bahama the white trunks on the left, Griffith in black trunks on the right. Ari Kessler, the referee. Looks as though he's been told to pick up the pace a little bit. Again, the equalizer, first one, then the other. the bell. Next Saturday, the fight of the week moves to Ogden, Utah for a 15-round NBA middleweight championship slugging match between Gene Fulmer and challenger Florentino Fernandez. It will be blacked out on TV in the Salt Lake City, Ogden area. Always in shape, Fulmer is a relentless puncher, wearing his opponents down with a two-fisted hail of blows from every angle. Only once has he been stopped by Sugar Ray Robinson. He's won 53 out of 59, scoring 23 knockouts. Since turning middleweight, Fernandez has fought three times. Results, three knockouts. Del Moya, Rory Calhoun, and French contender Marcel Pigou. His best punch is a left hook. Fernandez has won 30 of 32 fights, 24 of them by knockouts. Gene Fulmer defends his title against Florentino Fernandez. Brought to you by El Producto, America's largest selling quality cigar, and by the Gillette Safety Razor Company. Round six ended with a bang. Here's round seven at Madison Square Garden. Bahamer in white, Griffith in black. There have been no knockdowns. A lot of maneuvering, a lot of fainting. Most of the forcing, and Bahama is a very good counter puncher. Solid left hook by Bahama. 1 minute to go in round seven. Bottom of the second right hand punch, and Bahama is one. been using the right hand much. He's used the left hook and a jab mostly. Every so often, Bahama moves that right hand away from his chin. And that's the opening that Griffith is looking for. Round eight, half over. Noticed it. on round nine. Every time. The well middle of